Hi there, I'm Greg with Sonnax, and today we're in the shop looking at 6L80 and 6L90 planets. And what we want to be able to do is remove the lube dam and install the Sonnax lube dam. And this is really important because you have contaminants that can come up underneath here through these tiny little lube holes right here. And they end up, the oil goes under the lube dam, gets captured, and then is forced down into the pinion pins to lube the planet. And the problem is that over time and mileage, and if you have converter failure or whatever might have failed, contaminants get trapped underneath this lube plate and really can accumulate to be quite a lot of metal and material in there. And the only way to clean it out is to remove it. And once it's removed, it's destroyed and it's damaged. Now, these contaminants are a real problem. A lot of people know that after a rebuild, 4, 5, 6 failure can be a common repeat failure. And you know, I just like to point out that on that one shift, you have 7 valves and 2 solenoids involved. And that doesn't include the pressure regulator valve and some of the other main valves. So there's a lot going on in this transmission. Everything has to work perfectly to keep the shift timing as intended. And any little piece of contaminant can stick a valve, slow things down, and burn up your transmission. So getting those contaminants out is important. Getting the lube dam off is one of the ways we get the contaminants out. Now you can remove the lube dam by putting it in a lathe and cutting it, which works really well. You can get in there and chisel it off, but there's a risk of nicking this or doing other damage, and it's just a lot of hammering and chiseling, and it's not very good. What we're going to show here is a way to use your arbor press or other press to get these off pretty easily. So what we want to first do is press right in this area and push this center portion down. So I have just a bearing race that is just a little bit bigger than this diameter right here. And it's going to sit right about there. And we're going to push it down. And then we're going to come back with a little bit larger race out here and get this lube dam to pivot and pop up and pop off. So that's what we're going to do right now. This is just a core piece that we have here, and I'm going to start with this smaller bearing race just outside this ridge, and just stack some stuff up here. And we're going to give this a good crimp. And you can see that lube dam bend in there. That's really what we want to look for. Now that this is pressed down, we can come back with a little larger race, and we want to just catch this ridge right here. And this is about the size of a 4L80 sprag race. And then come right down. And again, without too much effort, that will just... And this should just pop right off. And again, here you can see this is just loaded with all kinds of contamination. And that's the type of stuff that'll ruin your day when it gets its works its way out into the fluid and can potentially stick a valve or a solenoid. So getting this off can be pretty easy. Just you want to get yourself a few different races, different sizes, and have them set, and then boom, 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 you can pop this off. And then next we're going to show is putting the new one on. So for that, I have this other carrier that is a little bit cleaner. Just wipe that off. All right, and then this is the Sonnax lube dam. And it, like I say, it pops on and it's held down by this crimp right here. So we just want to set it in place. You could use many different round parts you might have around your transmission shop. But this is a RFE underdrive overdrive plate, a 4T65 drum. It'll sit right on there. And we're just going to come around, and it shouldn't take much. It'll just pop right on. And just like that, we have the lube dam back on. So easy removal, easy installation, get those contaminants out of there, and have a better rebuild. Thanks a lot for watching.